Good morning, all of you students. We are doing the chapter magnet. In this chapter, we discussed all the topics related to magnet, and then we also completed the exercises A, B, C, and D. Now, from today, I'm going to start explaining the answers of the question of exercise E. Question number one is: distinguish between the following permanent magnet and temporary magnet. And the second one is magnetic and non-magnetic materials. Permanent magnet. A magnet which retains its magnetism for a long period of time is known as permanent magnet. Temporary magnet. A magnet which retains its magnetism for only a short period of time is known as temporary magnet. Once again, a magnet which retains its magnetism for a long period of time is known as permanent magnet. And a magnet which retains its magnetism for only a short period of time is known as temporary magnet. Now, magnetic and non-magnetic material. Magnetic materials, materials which get attracted towards a magnet are called magnetic materials, like iron, steel, etc. Then non-magnetic materials, materials which do not get attracted towards a magnet are known as non-magnetic materials like plastic, paper, etc. Now, in question number two, the two bar magnets P and Q are kept as shown in the diagram, and there is repulsion between these two magnets. Now, the questions are: if point C represents the south pole of the magnet Q, which point represents the north pole of magnet P? And the next question is, what will happen when the end D of magnet Q is brought towards the end B of magnet P? The first question, if C represents the south pole and it is shown in the diagram that there is repulsion between the magnets, and if C is south pole of the magnet Q, then B of magnet P will also be south pole. And if B will be south pole, then A will be the north pole. So the answer of question number A, if point C represents the south pole of the magnet Q, then point A represents the north pole of magnet P. Now the next one, when the end D of magnet Q is brought towards the end B, D is the north pole of magnet Q. So when it brought near towards the end B of magnet P, then there will be an attraction between these two magnets P and Q, because now unlike poles are towards each other, so there will be attraction between these two magnets. Now, in question number three, describe in brief the construction of a compass needle, state its main use. The compass consists of a magnetic needle pivoted at its center, and it is free to rotate in a horizontal plane. The needle is fitted in a horizontal box having a glass cover. The compass also has a dial with directions marked on it. This is the construction of compass needle, and the use of it is to find direction. That means it is used to find direction. Now, in question number four, draw a label diagram to show the proper way of storing two bar magnets when they are not in use. State the advantage of such a proper storing. The diagram to show the storing of a bar magnet is shown on the screen. Now, the advantages. If the bar magnets are stored properly, they retain the magnetism for a long period of time. This is the advantage of storing a bar magnet, proper storing of a bar magnet. Now, question number five. Write the different ways through magnets can be made to lose their magnetism. Magnets can be made to lose their magnetism when they are not stored properly, heated, mishandled, dropped, or hammered. These are the ways by which magnets can be made to lose their magnetism. Now, question number six and the last question of this exercise. The question is, Anustha saw a steel clip at the bottom of a very shallow puddle of water. She used a magnet to take out this clip without wetting her hands or the magnet. Describe how she must have done this. Now, I think that she had kept the magnet inside a polythene bag, and with the help of a string or a stick, she dipped the magnet inside the puddle. Steel, being a magnetic material, get attracted towards the magnet which was kept in the polythene bag. Then she took out the steel clip which got stuck to the magnet, and in this way Anustha take out that steel clip out of the puddle with the help of magnet without wetting her hands or the magnet. So students, we have completed all the exercises of this chapter. So that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.